Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love you tomorrow. Hi, and welcome to another edition of Ask Lois, brought to you by Tropic Isle Living, the natural and the traditional way to a healthy, beautiful you. Today we're going to be talking about sorrel and how to make it. Sorrel is one of the things that we as the Caribbean people, particularly Jamaicans, like to drink around Christmas time. So in honor of the season, I will show you how to make a lovely sorrel drink. Now this is my recipe, okay, and some others may have a different take on it. I don't put rum in mine, obviously, for the holidays, because I don't want you to go dip too much rum in there and give somebody, and then they get drunk and then they call me up. Don't want that, okay? So anyway, that was just a little humor right there. The ingredients that you need to make a good sorrel drink, okay, and you also can drink it as a tea too, is you need some pimento, which is called allspice. You need some dried sorrel, which is right here. And you also need some cloves, and you have to be a little bit careful with the cloves because you don't want to put too much, because then that would be the overriding taste and you don't want to do that. So just a little cloves just to enhance the flavor. You also need some cinnamon leaves and some cinnamon stick. Now I've already pre-prepared in a pot all the ingredients that I put together. And with the sorrel tea, it's like a two-day process, to be honest with you. Sometimes it can even take weeks, depending on if you want to ferment your sorrel, which you can do that. But right now, I'm just going to teach you the two-day regimen. So what we do first is that we get all the ingredients together, which is the pimento, the sorrel, as well as the cloves, and the cinnamon leaf and the cinnamon stick. Now, for this particular recipe, you're going to need about, I would say, about 10 to 20 pimento seeds, or allspice, about two cups of the sorrel drink, or 2.5 cups, okay? You can use a teacup if you want, okay? And then you can also add your cloves to it, as well as your cinnamon stick. Now, you're gonna put all these ingredients together overnight in a pot with water, and you're gonna let it sit, okay? And after you let it sit, then you're going to start boiling it. So I like to do mine in a very concentrated form. So after I boil it, and you boil it until you see that the leaves or the sorrel, they're not in their dried form anymore and they got bigger. And after they boil, you're gonna let it sit. You're gonna let it sit for a couple of hours and let it cool. And when it's cool, that is when you can add your sugar and so forth. So now it has to be cool. When I say room temperature cool, that's how cool it has to be. So right now we're gonna put it on the stove and we are going to boil it. Now why is this drink so important to our culture? It's because of, you know, when we were celebrating back in the days, Christmas was such a good relief for ancestors to kind of like just take a chill pill from their everyday work in the fields and so forth and so on. And not only that, we know that now that sorrel is so good for you, it's high in antioxidants. It also, research shows that it also aids in prevention of cancer. And I just happen to like how it tastes as well, okay? So we're gonna be boiling right now and we will be back. So as I said, this is a concentrated version. So after it cools and we strain off the residue, I'm going to put another pot of cold water, okay, on that, and then that's when I'll start my mixing. And I will only add sugar to the taste, or sometimes what I will do, I will leave some of the cloves as well as pimento seeds in there and let it sit even further while it is just like marinating, so to speak. Okay, so we're just gonna just turn this pot off, and then, you know, in a couple of hours we're gonna strain this, and then you can see how I mix it while it is cool, okay? All right. almost the end of the day and our sorrel has cooled and we have strained off the residue and now we've added some sugar to taste. And hopefully you have brown sugar, not the white sugar, so to speak. Now, I purposely didn't add any ginger to this mixture. And ginger for sorrel in Jamaica is a key ingredient because I don't know if anybody have any ginger sensitivity or so forth and so on. But please, if you don't, add at least maybe, I'd say 2 sprigs of ginger like this. Don't make it too much because then the ginger will be overbearing and then you have ginger beer instead of a sorrel drink, okay? This is the end result, all right? And remember, I told you I made a concentrated form. So you're gonna add water to taste, okay? I like it very strong, almost kind of very thick. So if you notice, this is very dark. Some sorrel drink doesn't look as dark as mine, but that's how I like it, okay? If you have any questions, please do feel free to call us at Tropic Isle Living at 770-837-3236. Like us on Facebook. We do have a Twitter account. You can always find us there. We give out a lot of good information. Okay, so until next time, this is Ask Lois and brought to you by Tropic Isle Living, the natural and the traditional way to an absolutely healthy, beautiful you.